Hey guys, this is AnswerLog, and from 53mm high-fidelity drivers to a virtual 7.1 surround sound USB card, the Kingston HyperX Cloud 2 has a lot to offer. The original Cloud 1 was one of the most favorited gaming headsets of the consumer market, so are the Cloud 2s a worthy successor? As we open up the box, we're immediately presented with top-notch packaging, which secures the headphones, a cardioid detachable microphone, an extra set of Allure ear pads, a USB 7.1 surround sound card, an airplane adapter, and finally a mesh bag to store and transport your headphones with. Starting off with the build quality, the headphones are made of a durable plastic and some metal. Covering the majority of the ear cups are a nice sturdy-looking brushed metal plate with the HyperX logo. It's also kind of a double-edged sword because it looks and feels very premium, but it also attracts fingerprints at the same time. Connecting the ear cups to the headband is also another brushed metal material, and once again very sturdy. However, where the metal piece and the headband meet is where the weakest spot is. The metal material part moves around in the socket, allowing for the ear cups to swivel and move backwards and forwards a little bit. Given it kind of squeaks where the metal part is moving around, I'm going to assume it wasn't done on purpose. The headphones still feel pretty sturdy and is not of concern since while the headphones are on your head, they stay completely still and there's no issue. There's also a nice braided cable with a 3.5mm headphone jack on the end. Finally, we get to the headband, which is very comfortable and also looks very nice. It has some material similar to leather, and I'm not sure if it actually is leather, but it has HyperX branding stitched into the material. It also has some nice accent stitching, which on my model was gray, and it literally ties the whole look together. The headphones are extremely comfortable, allowing me to wear these for hours and hours on end. The headphone has a leatherette style ear pad made of 100% memory foam, and they're very plush, conforming to the shape of your head. You can also change the ear pads for the included velour ones, but the velour ones were less plush and a lot harder, so I stuck to the default ones. The clamping force was a little tight at first, but the more I wore the headphones, the looser they became, and the more comfortable they got. Moving on to what makes the headset a gaming headset, the microphone. The microphone is detachable, and while it's off, Kingston includes a little plug for the exposed 3.5mm jack. The microphone can also move towards or away from your mouth, depending on where you want it. Finally, the microphone has a windscreen to prevent the popping noises from pee sounds. So let's do a quick test of how these sound, and then you can judge for yourself how it sounds. This is a test of the HyperX Cloud 2 microphone. It sounds pretty good for a gaming headset, but definitely not actual broadcast microphone quality. So you be the judge of how it sounds, and now we're going on to test how well it picks up the pee popping sounds. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. A peck of pickled peppers Peter Pitcher picked. If Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, where's the peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked? So you be the judge of the microphone quality on these headphones. Finally, we talk about the sound quality and the virtual 7.1 surround sound. The included dongle has a braided cable and connects via USB to your computer. The dongle has a clip to your shirt or your mouse pad, and on the side there's a nice mic mute switch. Furthermore, there are volume rockers for both the headset and the mic volume, and there's an illuminated HyperX logo. But more importantly, there's a big button in the middle to turn on that virtual 7.1 surround sound. I noticed that the 7.1 surround made the sound feel a lot more distant and like it was coming from a wider soundstage. Also, some sounds would sound like they were coming from behind me or some different places between the forward, backwards, left, and right. And while I'm not quite sure that it gives you the edge in gaming due to this, it definitely makes your gameplay sound much more immersive. One last thing to note is that the 7.1 only works if you're playing the right kind of audio, like games, but not so much songs. Without the 7.1 surround sound on, the headset sounds like any other headset with good bass, mids, and highs. The highs are crisp and the mids aren't overshadowed by the bass, but the bass is very nice. Nothing is being overshadowed and everything is balanced out nicely. So in conclusion, the HyperX Cloud 2s are a worthy successor to the widely popular Cloud. They offer outstanding comfort, good looks, and amazing surround sound. Really, the only con I can think of is the weak hinge connecting the ear cups to the headband. Anyways guys, thanks so much for watching. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, be sure to subscribe for more videos like this. Anyways guys, thanks so much for watching once again, and I'll catch you guys in my next video.